Despite the efforts by the Uganda Blood Transfusion Services to collect blood and supply hospitals, the demand and need for blood in the country remains quite high. The high demand is mostly driven by malaria patients, especially anemic children, expectant mothers who face a number of pregnancy complications, sickle cell patients, road accident victims, and the increasing surgical operations, among others. In a move to curb blood shortage, Uganda is set to host the Africa Blood Transfusion Conference next month. The conference will bring together scientists, leading experts, and stakeholders in the field of blood transfusion from across the continent. Medics from the Ministry of Health and Makerere University are optimistic that this will provide unique opportunity for networking among professionals in the field to solve a number of challenges. The experts are expected to devise new ways of sustaining blood transfusion services in Africa, explore new clinical approaches, including innovations and technologies.
We are going to see new innovations in accessing blood donors. We are going to see innovations which we should embrace in mobilizing blood donors. We are going to see new things in managing a blood donor or a group of blood donors. Our director has been encouraging you to donate.
Innovative approaches which we want is that even within the blood which we collect, how can we efficiently use it? Because you can make many different products. You might just only want platelets, so we can get platelets and give you. You might want plasma, and we can get you plasma. If you want whole blood, then we give you one whole blood. So those are some of the innovation which we are looking at. From one unit of blood, can we use one unit to serve many what? Many patients. So those are the innovations which we think.
According to the World Health Organization, a country is considered self-sufficient of safe blood if it collects blood to the tune of 1% of its population. Uganda's total population currently stands at about 48 million people and is projected to increase to 55 million people by 2025. This translates the demand for safe blood at 457,000 units of blood annually. The director in charge of clinical services at the Ministry of Health, Dr. Charles Olaro, says the coming conference will discuss regulatory frameworks.
At the moment, the country is in the process of developing a new legal mechanism which can be able to support one, the transfusion services in this country. Other countries, they have it as a combined what? A combined law. So we are looking at it like that aspect.
The executive director of the Uganda Blood Transfusion Services, Dr. Dorothy Cheyune, is optimistic about hosting the Congress. However, she is concerned about the issues of selling blood from health facilities.
Many times, accountability is not there because at times this blood is taken elsewhere, taken to other healthcare. That's why they don't want to account. I think this is what for us we think. Because they are not using that blood in the healthcare facility. Otherwise, if they were using that blood in the healthcare facility, then why don't you account?
This conference, scheduled to run from 1st to 4th March, will run under the theme Safe and Sustainable Blood Services in Africa, New Clinical Advances, ICT Innovations and Technologies in Transfusion. Story compiled by Jelet Namuaya for the news.